We just finished describing people, their emotions and feelings, and also describing whatever things around them. Now, we are going to concentrate mainly on objects, okay? So, when you describe things, it will be easier for you to tell someone, okay, this is what it is. Like earlier we saw how a person is asked to receive a few people at the airport, and you gave a we gave a very good description of four people. Now, in case you lose something or you want somebody to bring something from another room or another house, so you have to describe, isn't it? Describe what that object is like. So now we are going to see how a person is lodging a complaint at the police station. Okay, what is your handbag like? All of you carry a handbag, or you men carry a laptop bag. What is it like? Each bag may differ one from the other, isn't it? One may have a leather bag, a brown leather bag, or one may have a black leather bag. Ladies may have colorful bags matching to their dresses. It may be flowery ones, or it may be a canvas one. So all these descriptions make a lot of change, like when we have to talk to others. For spoken English, all these are very, very important. Okay? Now, at the police station, I'm going to read a conversation between one Mrs. Gayatri and the police inspector, and then I'm going to ask you questions. Let's see how well you listen. At the police station, okay? This is describing objects. We have been doing describing people and clothes, and now we are going to do describing objects. And here, at the police station. Listen carefully, Mrs. Gayatri. Good morning, Inspector. I'd like to report a missing handbag. Inspector. Good morning, madam. Sit down and give me the details as to where you lost the handbag, when you came to know it was lost, and how it can be identified. Mrs. Gayatri. Sir, I was in the route 23A bus this morning. As it was a peak hour, the bus was jam-packed. When the bus reached my stop at Egmore, I had to get down jostling through the standees with a handbag on my shoulder and a few files in my arms. I was pushed along till I reached the footboard and managed to get down just as the driver drove off. It was only there I realized that my handbag was missing. Inspector. Please describe your handbag, ma'am. Mrs. Gayatri. It is a black rectangular leather bag with a long tubular strap of the same material. It is of patent leather with a glossy finish. The bag is about 18 inches into 12 inches in size, with three compartments. The center compartment has a zip, while each of the outer ones is closed with flaps and brass clasps. In the center of the clasp, there are five red stones in a ring. In the right hand corner of one side is stuck a tiny cluster of yellow plastic flowers with green velvety felt leaves. The compartment on this side contains my phone book, diary, several old bills and receipts. The compartment on the other side contains a Revlon burgundy red lipstick, a beige face compact, a small pocket mirror, a packet of premium tissue paper, and a pair of round sunglasses in its case. In the center compartment are my HBSC credit card, ICICI ATM card, and an SBI debit cum ATM card, my office ID card, and a copy of my salary slip are in a zipped pouch along with ₹1,500 in cash of 100 rupees denomination. There may be other items like a cello gripper, blue ballpoint pen, some hair clips, toothpicks, I'm not sure. Inspector: okay ma'am, you have given us a fairly good description. We'll do our best to help you. Just hand in a formal complaint to the constable who's seated in the next room and get a copy of the first information report, which is FIR, first information report. Mrs. Gayatri: thank you, sir. Inspector: and don't forget to leave your phone number and address for contact. Mrs. Gayatri: of course, I shan't forget. Thank you once again. Okay, this is a conversation at the police station, and it's a very normal happening, people losing handbags in a bus because there are pickpocketers and they try to steal handbags and ATM cards and all that. So this Mrs. Gayatri has lost a lot of things in the bag. She's lost 1500 rupees, but she's lost so many ATM cards and other credit cards and all that, plus a few lipsticks, and she has also given a description of the handbag. Shall we have you listen carefully? Now you're going to recollect, and we are going to write down the description of the bag. Okay, now between whom is the conversation? Between Mrs. Gayatri and the inspector. Okay, now what has Mrs. Gayatri lost? She's lost her handbag. Okay, now describe the handbag. It is a leather handbag. It's made of leather, and it has a, it's made of patent leather, and it has a, with glossy finish, it has a glossy finish. Okay, and then there are a cluster. Oh, okay, now the straps are also of the same tubular, same leather. Okay, sometimes the bag will be canvas and the straps will be leather, or vice versa. Here we have the same straps made of the same leather. Then it has a cluster of flowers of what color flowers? A cluster of yellow flowers. And green velvety leaves. And green. velvety leaves. And it has three compartments. Okay, three compartments, of which the center compartment what does it contain? How many credit cards? It has HBSC credit card, ICICI HBSC credit card, then ICICI ATM card, and then what else do they have? State Bank of India, SBI credit card. What else does it contain? ID card, office ID card. And also a salary slip. Then some receipts. Receipt, this P is silent. You don't say receipt, it is receipt. Okay, it's pronounced as receipt. Receipts, then hair clips. Most important, a Revlon lipstick. Revlon, a burgundy color lipstick. Then beige color compact case. Compact powder. What else can you hair clips, okay, and toothpicks and all that. Pocket mirror. Okay, etc. So we have a detailed description of the handbag. And what color is a black rectangular leather bag? Okay, handbag is black rectangular . Some will be roundish in shape, some will be oblong. This is rectangular, black rectangular one with clasps. With what clasp? Flaps and brass clasp. Okay, here you have a detailed description of a bag. See, now anybody, like if you give a complaint, if you go and give a complaint for a handbag, if you just say a black handbag, and I go to the police station and say it's my handbag, it's also black, see, the policeman will be at a loss whether to give it to me or to you, isn't it? But if you had given a detailed description of your handbag like this, the contents of the handbag also, then I cannot go and claim it because it's a detail. See, handbag, black rectangular with brass clasps. Then it's made of patent leather with glossy finish. Some may have a very rough finish, some may have a glossy finish. Then straps, tubular, same leather, made of same leather. a cluster of yellow flowers and green velvety leaves on the outside. Three compartments it has inside. The center compartment contains the HBSC credit card, ICICI ATM card, SBI State Bank of India credit card, office ID card, beige compact powder and pocket mirror. So what more do you need? Anybody can, and also 1500 rupees and rupees 1500 in cash. Okay, so all this put together, it makes it very clear whoever the owner is, it can be given. Maybe if the robber or the thief had taken away the money, he may not be using the Revlon lipstick and all, isn't it? Burgundy lipstick and salary slip and receipts and hair clips, he may not need it. So he could have taken the HBSC credit card and all that, and also the money. But at least the remaining things will be there to identify your handbag. So this way, when you talk at a police station, you can give a beautiful description. You should know how to describe. Okay, so in spoken English, this is also a very important aspect where you describe objects. Okay, now I'm going to give you different types of describing things. Maybe I'm going to come to your house. Okay, I want to come to your house, and I don't know, like, you've given me the address, but I still want some more identification as to how your house will be. And so you have to give me a better picture of your house. Let's see, we'll put it in a dialogue and let's see how it goes. Take down, you can use all this for describing your handbags or the words that are used and all that. We'll go on to the next one. Okay, now we are going to have an imaginary dialogue between Geeta and Sita. Now, Geeta wants to come to Sita's house to give her an invitation for her daughter's birthday party. Okay, and she wants to know, apart from the address, nowadays, you know, in Chennai, it's very difficult to locate anybody's house. So, because there are old numbers, new numbers, an umpteen number of streets and by streets. So, she's asking for a landmark and also the description of the house. And we are going to see how she describes her house. Okay? Let's see. Geeta. This is over the phone. Okay? Telephonic conversation this is. Over the phone she's asking Geeta. Hello, is it? Sita? Sita. Yes. Sita speaking. May I know who's calling? Who's calling? Here, who apostrophe is, that is who is calling? Geeta. Hi Sita, this is Geeta, your friend. This is Geeta, your friend. I would like to invite you personally Personally means in person, okay? Personally, for my son's birthday party. Can you give me the address? Your address and landmark. To make my visit easier, okay. Sita now replies. Hi, Geeta. You can give an exclamatory mark. Okay. Hi, Geeta. It's a pleasant surprise. Well, the address my house number is 123 W block, we can say Adyar Chennai. Okay, the landmark is it is next to a grocery shop. Grocery means what? All the provision things that you buy. Grocery shop. What shall we name? Murugan stores. My house is a grey building with red border okay. A fleet of steps goes from the ground floor to the first floor, that is outside, okay. In some houses, the steps will be inside the house, whereas this house, it is outside. Okay, and there is a covered car park. There is a covered car park. Where a blue colored Hero, I mean Honda Civic will be parked. What else can we say? There's a tree. See, Adya, there are a lot of trees, isn't it? There is a huge tree. Huge neem tree outside the house. The house has a grill. What color gate? Black. Has a grilled, black grilled gate. Okay. And what else can we describe with a post box? Okay, with a milk box. On it. Okay, so Geeta says, thank you, Sita. Sita, I shall be there in the evening, or I shall see you in the evening. So, Geeta is planning to visit Sita. And Sita has given a very descriptive, she's given a very beautiful description of a house. So there won't be any problem at all for Geeta to find Sita's house. Now, shall we read the dialogue? This is a telephonic conversation between Geeta and Sita. I'm going to read it out and you'll see how beautifully Sita explains to Geeta the description of a house and how it will be easy for Geeta to find a house to come and visit her. Okay, Geeta. Hello, is it Sita? Sita. Yes, Sita speaking. May I know who's calling? Geeta. Hi Sita, this is Geeta, your friend. I would like to invite you personally for my son's birthday party. Can you give me your address and landmark to make my visit easier? Immediately Sita listens to her and says, Hi Geeta, it's a pleasant surprise. Well, my house number is 123 W Block, 12th Street, Adyar, Chennai. The landmark is, it is next to a grocery shop, Murugan Stores. My house is a grey building with red border. A fleet of steps goes from the ground floor to the to the first floor. And there is a covered car park where a blue colored Honda Civic will be parked. There is a huge neem tree outside the house. The house has a black grilled gate with a milk box on it. Okay, and Immediately Geeta says, "Thank you, Sita. I shall see you in the evening." So evening, Geeta is going to visit Sita, and she has given a beautiful, Sita has given a beautiful description of her house. Isn't it very easy for you when somebody gives you a proper description of a place? It's easy to locate, isn't it? So this is the way you describe objects. Maybe inside the house also you can have a beautiful description. Like if you want to buy a house from a real estate owner, he may tell you like it's a house built on 1500 square feet, and if he gives a description like as you enter there is a dining room, there is a hall or the drawing room, and then there are two bedrooms on either side with the huge French windows outlooking a lawn, and then as you go straight in there is a kitchen with a modular kitchen with a chimney and everything, and a huge sink to wash vessels, and outside the kitchen there is a wash area where you can keep your washing machine, and also there is a veranda there, a balcony like veranda, ground floor, you call it a veranda. And there is a small gate which goes out to the backyard where you have a lot of trees and plants, and you have a pump outside. See, all this will let your imagination see right before your eyes what the description would be in reality. Okay, so this is how you explain objects. Okay, it's very important for your spoken English. Next, I'm going to give you John's room, and I'm going to give you some fill-ups with clue words, and you're going to do it. So have you taken down this dialogue? Okay, I'm going to give you a very interesting work for you. I'm going to give you a passage describing John's room with a lot of omissions, and I'm going to give you some key words where you are going to fill up the blanks. Okay, so you'll know how to describe a person's room. Okay, shall we do it? Okay, let's do it now. Take down. John has rented a room near his college. The room is on the dash floor. Dash floor of the house. It is a small dash room. Okay. Facing south. It has a dash
It has a large dash.
On the south
along the
dash walls are two doors one opening onto a dash with two okay. Okay, next line. The other door opens into a dash passage. There is a dash stairway leading down to the dining room. On the other end, is a dash stairway leading to the terrace. Okay, now I'll give you the words here. Let's see whether you are able to. Okay, balcony, grilled narrow spiral winding. Okay. Okay, how many blanks are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I've given you the clue words. Have you finished? If you haven't finished, I'm going to help you. So, what is this? This is John's room. Okay, and you're going to fill up John's room. Okay. John has a rented room near his college. The room is on the which floor? First floor. Okay. So, first here. First floor of the house. It is a small house. It is a small house facing south. Okay, next one. It has a large, what can we say, large dining room. Dining room on the south. Along the dash walls are two doors, red colored. Okay, so this will be 4. Along the red colored walls are two doors, one opening on to a dash with 2 foot high, okay, grilled wall, one opening onto a dash with 2 foot high, okay, one opening onto a balcony, what number is this? Spiral, first, two, three, four, five, balcony, with 2 foot high grilled wall. This will be 6. Okay, 6. The other door opens into a narrow passage. There is a curved There's a curved stairway. So this will be 8. Curved stairway leading down to the dining room. On the other end is a, what is left now? Spiral winding, you know, going in circular motion. Spiral winding. Stairway leading to the terrace. Okay. So, have you written all the blanks now? Now you have a full description of John's room or John's house or room. Okay, small little house which he calls it his room, and that is where he stays. Now, beautiful description of a house, isn't it? So, this also you should know. When you learn spoken English, you should learn to describe not only people and things, also houses. Okay, so I am sure you have become well versed now in all this.